Catholic Storage. We're all over town.
Barbara, it's time to go to work.
Come on.
But her cold medicine made her drowsy. If only she could go back and take Sudafed instead. Sudafed. Relief begins in 22 minutes without drowsiness.
Some car makers wouldn't put kids and fun in the same sentence. We think they belong in the same car. Introducing the new Access from Nissan.
My friend, you're slowing down and you're approaching middle age. It's still the shank of the evening.
Yeah. Well, watching you win money is a distinct pleasure, not worth paying gas to say. Besides, the wife wants me home. You know,
You're whipped. I'm telling you, you're whipped. There's still money on the table.
You want blood from a stone? I couldn't win a hand with a gun. Take it easy, fellas. See you next week.
Be good to your wife, Harvey.
It's 12 o'clock. Bye-bye, Harvey.
I'm not praying. See, what the doc doesn't understand that there are some of us who are still working stiffs with major obligations.
Mortgages, car loans.
Serious commitments.
You're breaking my heart.
I myself have undertaken to provide an Ivy League education for my bookie son.
Oh, everyone's a comedian.
Mm-hmm. One of the things that really worries me about your little brother is the way he keeps his emotions all bottled up inside. I check. A McDaniel family trait, a predilection to a poker face, self-ass.
I'll go in a dollar. Paul, are you in?
You wait much longer, old buddy. That tie will come back into style.
Who died and made him Mr. Blackwell?
Oh, listen.
Topsy part two by...
Junior Walker and the All-Star.
Ah, this is Bill Collins.
That's Cozy Cole, 1962.
I think we got a winner here.
Come on, Paul, better don't.
Oh, Daddy, take it easy. Paulie always takes his time.
Yeah, that's true, but I do have to be in court tomorrow morning, and I would at least like to finish this hand first.
So what is it, $11? It's a little too rich for my blood counselor. I think what I'll do is fold and let you big boys play.
Okay, Danny boy, now you in or out.
Oh... 10 more.
Adios, muchachos.
Good idea.
I'll raise another 20.
Ooh. Come on, Charlie. It's supposed to be a friendly game.
Danny, if I don't have something hidden under here, that just might be the friendliest thing that I ever did.
I don't have 20.
You can go light.
Yeah, you just go light.
Go light.
Go ahead. I'll cover you, Danny.
Can't afford it.
So what did you have?
You'll never know.
I knew you were bluffing.
Danny, you want to see what I got? You call a hand.
What's the big deal? Just want to see your cards.
Whoa, hey, Danny, take his cards.
Yeah, well, you want to play? You play by the rules, pal. Whoa, Paul, inbound, baby. Here it is.
Hey, Bye. Hey, Steve, give him go.
Yes, we got two.
Hey, Paul, take my deal. Would you call the game?
Sure.
Oh, hey, champ, you sure you want another one of those?
Hey, I'm fine. I'm okay.
Oh, come on, man. Give him a break. I'm telling you, he just watered the plants yesterday. Come on. Whoa, watch those stairs, kiddo. They'll move right up on you.
Yeah, maybe we should put one of those signs on them. My name is Danny McDaniel.
Am I the only one who notices that you are consistently the big winner?
See, that probably has to do with a steel trap memory,
clean
living, and a razor sharp mind.
Probably has something to do with the fact that it's your apartment, your cards, your table.
That too.
All right, there you go. Now, you tell Lisa to give you some vitamin C, take some aspirin, and I'll talk to you in the morning, okay? Okay, yeah.
He's fine. He's good.
Drive fast, okay?
Especially around curves.
Hey, thanks a lot, fellas, for tonight.
Yeah. Sorry about that.
That's okay, coach.
Hey, that reminds me. We got a game Monday at the Y.
Monday,
okay?
Right.
Are you going to be there, Paul?
I'll be there.
All right.
Oh, can I play two, coach? Oh, can I? Don't pick me last, okay?
Won't be a bad idea if we got there about an hour early so we can get a little bit of
one on one.
Yeah, well, the way you guys play, you know, it's like a week of one.
Get out of here.
All right. See you Monday.
Yeah. Steve, you got a minute? I'll buy a drink. Come on.
Yeah, I'm still wired. I'll walk you to your place.
Gee, old buddy, old pal. You know you're about as good a friend as I've got.
This is about Danny, right?
So I feel I can say things to you, things that maybe someone else couldn't.
Listen, don't start, Charlie. I know you don't like him. I know.
This isn't the first time.
See, I know,
Now, you yourself are a fine human being.
Oh, yeah, right.
But your little brother's a major jerk.
Oh, come on, Charlie, for example.
Well, first of all, a man can't hold his liquor.
Oh, if I weren't such a fine human being, I might remind a certain somebody who happened to be the best man at my wedding that certain somebody threw up all over my wife.
I was young then.
Exactly, about the same age as Dan.
Yeah, well, more to the point of this discussion. He's a god-awful poker player.
Yeah, well, that much is true. I can't deny it.
So what are you saying, Charlie?
I think you're an admirable brother taking the boy under your wing.
Yeah.
I'm just asking it not to be when your wing is in the company of my wing. Capiche?
You really don't like him, do you, Charlie?
You're not gonna be hurt, man?
No, I ain't gonna be hurt. Go ahead, tell me the truth.
I could happily go the rest of my life without ever seeing that little zipwad again.
Zipwad? I'll tell you what, Charlie, you're not gonna have to wait that long.
Why not?
Because starting Monday, I've invited him to fill out the rest
of
the
basketball. Nah, don't do this to me,
I'm telling you,
Nah, tell me this is a joke.
Stephen and Paul already agreed, man.
I hope he dribbles better than he bets.
Some women are great kissers. Some women are great dressers. Some you can take dancing. Some I've actually talked to.
Oh, you don't want much, do you?
I want all of them. That is not realistic, and you know it.
Oh, man.
Clean your dishes.
I'm sorry.
Okay, what happens if I agree with you and I marry somebody who's absolutely terrific? And then, on the honeymoon, I meet somebody who's absolutely perfect.
For one thing, you better make sure she's not looking for somebody who's absolutely perfect.
Oh, right. Touché. You got me.
Yeah.
Okay. So if you're not happy dating, what are you planning to do? Is there a Jewish equivalent to becoming a monk?
That's what I wanted to talk to you about.
Becoming a monk?
I'm thinking of getting back with Claire. I'm serious.
Well, that's terrific.
Claire and I have been reasonably friendly, you know, since the divorce. And it's no secret that I miss the hell out of Zach. You know, he's getting at that age where he just needs a father, you know? And Claire and I, we've been seeing each other once in a while.
Oh.
For lunch.
Oh.
Always at her instigation, so I'm pretty sure she's interested.
Oh, well, it's not my life, but for you, I think it's probably...
Oh, thank you for your considered opinion.
No, 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 there's a lot to be said for old Claire. Yeah, I think this separation, I think, was the best thing that could have happened to me. And for her. So now we're 2 years older. And she is so beautiful. Look at her. She looks great.
You want to hear something truly kinky? For the last couple of months, I swear I've been having sexual fantasies about my ex-wife.
I mean, that is bizarre.
What do you think? You think this is really dumb?
I think if this is what you really want, you'd better move quick.
Why?
Because lately I've been having sexual fantasies about your ex-wife.
Did Tagliarino call it with the background on that housing scam yet?
Yeah.
Damn, where is he? He's supposed
calling
to call.
For you on 17.
Well, that must be him, finally, right?
I think it's Claire.
Claire, huh?
Claire? Hi. Now, poker last night. Yes, with the same guys. Who, Steven? No, he doesn't. Claire, just last night he was telling me how much he missed you. Really, he did. Would I lie? It's true. When, today? No, I'm free for lunch. Yep. Sure, well, where would be good? Ah, that's perfect, honey. Yeah. No, I'll see you at 1 o'clock. Okay.
Oh, when you come to pick up Zach this weekend, remind me to show you the composition he wrote for English. I swear he's inherited your writing ability.
Will there be anything else?
No, we're finished, thanks. Would you like some dessert?
No, thank you.
Is there anything that you would like?
No, thanks.
Thanks. Remember how I always used to assume that you were finished?
Claire, listen, Paul. Oh, sorry.
No, go ahead. No, listen, it's not important.
No, please, go ahead.
You first, okay?
Okay. It's just that I'm really glad we've gotten to be friends again. But we're more than friends, aren't we? I mean, before we were never so open with each other, but now.
Oh, Paul. Claire.
I'm getting married again. Zach already knows, and it doesn't seem to be a problem because he really likes William.
William.
William, that's my fiance.
Fiance?
I know it's such a silly word when you're over 21. Oh, you don't know how nervous. That's one of the reasons why I keep asking you to lunch. I've been trying to steel myself to telling you, you know. I didn't know how you'd react. And somehow it's like I needed your blessing. It's like you were my father or something.
Well, Claire, it's not my life, but if that's what you need from me, then you know, of course, that you've got it. Just call me Pops.
Oh, no, Paul, I didn't mean that.
No, I understand. Claire, I couldn't be happier for you. Really.
I don't know why I was so nervous.
I'll pick this up whenever you're ready.
Right, don't go anywhere.
Oh, no, please, let me get this.
No, absolutely not. I'm paying for this lunch.
No, I wanted
Claire,
to talk to you.
I
invited
this
you.
Lunch. No, I've got it.
Claire. I really...
No, I'm paying for lunch. Thank you.
Man.
Familial disturbance at Bell's Point.
Family disturbance? I'll give you a family disturbance. Just get in there and get changed.
What are we doing?
A bunch of nobodies. Just get out of your rooms.
Yes. That's the problem, see? She's terrific. She's smart. She's beautiful.
All right. I can sure see why you want to break up with her.
Well, that's what I'm saying.
All right.
How do you break up with somebody when there's nothing wrong?
Charlie, I believe we're going to hear an accept in here somewhere, huh?
Accept?
Mm-hmm. So there it is.
It's dumb.
Oh, I think we can
have it, Charlie. And I know it's dumb. But you see, she has these enormous hands.
Hey, Paul, you okay?
I'm perfect. Oh. Hey, it would have been his foul. You're getting old, old man. You're losing a step on me.
It's my fault, really. Yeah. Hands? You're gonna break up with somebody just because of her hands?
We're talking hands like a first baseman's mitt.
skinny man. I can understand fat and bad legs. Woman with mustaches.
Go right, there you go.
But hands?
I'm telling you, this woman has hands like a Clydesdale has hooves.
Hey, man, admit it. You come in here telling stories, but you spend a lot of lonely nights.
I like my privacy. Oh. But when a woman spends the night, sometimes in the morning, I catch myself wondering, doesn't she have someplace to go?
Oh, I can't believe this guy, see? Because way down deep, you're about the most romantic guy I know.
Yeah, right.
It's true, and you know it.
Get out of here.
Danny, guard Paul. Work the left side of
me. Hey, I'm a bachelor. I like women. What's the big deal?
No big deal. But Paul's a bachelor, too, and he doesn't run around like you do.
No. Paul's not a bachelor. Paul's a married man who just doesn't have a wife.
Oh, Charlie, you hear this definition of bachelor?
Besides, Paul's thinking about getting back with Claire.
Oh, that's great, Paul.
Hey, that's terrific, Paul.
Isn't that wonderful, huh?
Come on, Paul.
Except that Claire's decided to get married to an investment banker named William.
I'm telling you guys, we had them, man. They weren't that good.
Coach, they beat us by 20 points.
Yeah, well, the game was a lot closer than that, right?
Yeah, it would have been if Paul hadn't kept on throwing the ball.
All right, hey, knock it off about Paul, all right?
I feel like there's something we should do.
Yeah, like what? If Paul doesn't want to talk about it, man, that's his business.
No, but you weren't there when he was thinking about it. I just think he's a lot more broken up about it than he's letting on.
Yeah. Hey, Thomas.
All right. What about him?
Oh, he's dirty already.
How can you tell?
Instinct.
I bet you a week's pay.
You mean you have a life?
It's not worth it. You don't make enough. You take this stuff. Oh, hey, police! Come on, lady. Come on, come on. Get the hell out of here. Oh, hey, stop. Police! Police! Get out of the way. Get out of the way. Come on, look out, lady.
Take care of him.
When the sniffles come, and they always do,
you'll remember the triaminic. They'll remember the love.
When they're coughing and sneezing and feeling blue,
you'll remember the triaminic. They'll remember the love.
Triaminic cough and cold medicine. Because you love your kids. Because you trust your doctor. And children's doctors say Triaminic is their number one choice.
You'll remember the Triaminic.
You know, you don't always have to eat dates, raisins, and walnuts to get high fiber.
Mm-hmm.
Why don't you try a different flavor of fruit and fiber?
No, no. This is delicious. You got chewy dates, plump raisins, and crispy walnuts.
Why don't you just taste this?
All right. Come here. I'll get it. Yeah. Oh, all right. Mmm. That's delicious, too. Here. That's all mine. Go on. No. Try something new. Go on.
Post fruit and fiber cereal with dates, raisins, and walnuts. Tastes so good, you forget the fiber.
After spending all morning at the auction, I shared the afternoon with two new treasures, a fine bone china cup and the taste of rich Swiss mocha from General Foods International Coffees.
Celebrate the moments of your life.
Why I like Stovetop in the Canister. When the crew from work's in a partying mood, Stovetop in the Canister's our favorite food. For 2, 6, or 8, it tastes so nice. We redo the scene so we can eat it twice.
Stovetop stuffing in the canister.
Anyone who offers you crack is not your friend. Say no. You be the boss.
Wednesday. All the stars are out. First, Diana Ross, Candace Bergen, and Audrey Hepburn.
I don't think I'll retire till I die.
On the Barbara Walters special. Then.
Oh, boy.
The moment everyone's been waiting for.
I thank you all sincerely.
The 61st Annual Academy Awards, live. Two spectacular events, one special evening. Wednesday.
Staff. I don't know. It was one of those cars. It was half car, half truck. And it was royal blue, and it had mag wheels, and it had one of these little scrolls by the door and by the bumper. You got that?
Yeah.
And it had a Maryland license, MPV, 1368. And don't tell me to take it easy. He's my brother.
I know. Just try to help.
And Thomas is a cop.
I know that.
Driver didn't even stop to look. I want him.
And we'll find him. Just calm down, okay? Is there anything else you remember?
What the hell else do you need? Model and license. You want me to run the MVA check for you?
Hey, you.
Give me a sponge. I can't see a thing.
Sir Roger Carlsgate, hold that back like that.
Stephen, listen to me.
Let me get in there.
We've had a flat EEG for more than half an hour now. Your machines are the only thing that's keeping him alive.
Suture.
Filker, catgut.
Catgut.
Look, Stephen, I know he's your patient.
He's my friend. Skin knife.
Don't do this to yourself. Why is this family so unlucky? How many times do I have to go through this?
Come on, Ma. Give it a rest.
Miriam, Thomas.
You know, you're really not helping things.
Don't say it, man.
Oh. I didn't say anything.
I know what you were thinking of, Charlie.
Thomas is the one kept in touch with everyone since high school.
I know.
He got us all back together. Started the poker game.
Yeah.
He kept pushing us, man. If anything would happen to
Charlie,
him, Paul.
Nothing is going to happen to him. He's going to be fine.
Place, guys.
I can't believe Thomas is dead. I can't believe I'm never going to see him again. OT, he was always there for us. T, back fear. Hut, hut, hut.
$100. Name the Four Seasons.
What? Summer, fall, winter, spring.
Princess Summer, fall, winter, spring.
No, I know. Rudy Valley. Frankie Valley, Rudy Valley, and Big Valley.
Oh, man. I always hated this white bread song. No, I didn't tell you guys. It was all during those years. But I hate it.
Thomas always hated this song.
We all hated this song.
Yeah, right. Sandy, gotta turn this stupid song off. Do you mind?
Over that flying bee.
Hey, you know what they say? The day you picture yourself dead, get out of here. That's the day. I mean, you can forget about your 21 years old, your first woman, you had your bar mitzvah. The day you picture yourself dead, that is the day. That you're an adult, you know? I mean, Thomas is dead, right? And I still don't believe that I'm gonna. I mean, I know, but I don't really believe down here, you know, that one day I'm really gonna grow.
Hey, buddy, I got a hot flash for you.
All right, excuse me, I forgot. You got all this crap about dying before you're 45.
Hey, Paulie, chill out.
It's not crap. Everybody in my family died before they were 45.
I know. You keep saying that like some stupid California mantra or something, you know?
Mantra.
They're gonna ward it off, right, Steve? You say it often enough, right?
Paulie, shut up. Just shut up.
I can't, okay? I'm scared. Is that all right with you? Because if it would have happened to me, Charlie, who would have really cared? You? You got Margaret, right? Claire's got... And Zach, I don't even feel like his father anymore, man. I feel like some stupid uncle or something. So if it would have been me that croaked on you, who cared about me?
I think what Charlie's trying to say is we'd come to a crummy bar and drink cheap bourbon for you, too.
Yeah. Listen, I would love to take you to breakfast this morning. No. No. I understand. Yeah, sure. No, look, I'll call your secretary and set it up. Patty. Steven.
Here you
go.
Hi, Daddy.
Hey, sugar bun.
You like my dress, Daddy?
It's beautiful. I love you. I love you both. You know that, don't you? I love you so much.
Come on, we gotta go. What's the matter, Daddy?
Here's your lunch, baby. Don't forget the gym today, okay?
I gotta go, Daddy. Love you.
Hollywood kiss.
I'm too old.
Baby, I'm sorry.
Mom is not easy. Moms cannot get sick. Without Alka-Seltzer Plus cold medicine, I can't take care of her. I can't be a mother. I can't do my job. Keeps my machine rolling. Helps me breathe in the morning. Helps that pain, that achiness feeling, the feverish feeling go away. Oh, this is the right stuff. Alka-Seltzer Plus cold medicine. This is the miracle worker.
Alka-Seltzer Plus cold medicine. Fast relief for tough winter colds.
I can't survive without it, okay?
You say your eyes are red, irritated, dry? Don't hide them. Help them with Clear Eyes. It gets rid of the redness and, unlike the leading brand, has an extra moisturizing ingredient. Remember, Clear Eyes moisturizes too.
Turkey and bacon sandwiches. With just one difference. These were made with mayonnaise, and these with Kraft mayonnaise, unbeaten in a national taste test. So if you go by taste, shouldn't you buy Kraft?
Swim with sea lions, glide with an eagle, catch some rays. All this and more on Tim McCarver's World of Adventure, tomorrow on ABC Sports.
Men will continue in a moment.
Tuesday, she loves to cook.
Here, dig in.
And she loves her kids.
This stuff is disgusting.
Wait till you taste it.
You'll love Roseanne. Then,
today I am a man.
Marty gets a death threat.
And tomorrow you are a corpse, but hey, sound the trumpets, let the good times roll. Say hallelujah, what are you, nuts?
The newest hit, Anything But Love. Then,
have you ever been, like, fixed up?
It's horrible.
What was it, did she have, like, a mustache?
Yeah,
what?
It's a big, thick one. I made her shave it, then I married her.
Yo.
30-something.
This is a Channel 8 News Brief.
Good evening. I'm Gloria Campos, Channel 8 News. Coming up tonight at 10, Senator Phil Graham is on the road trying to drum up funding support for the superconducting supercollider. Cleanup efforts stall in Alaska as the largest oil spill in U.S. history threatens the multi-million dollar fishing industry. And in Fort Worth, it's a dog's life for the handlers in town with 3,000 would-be champions. Join us for these stories and more, plus the Easter forecast tonight at 10.
I can't decide between the shrimp and steak special and the steak and shrimp special.
They're the same thing.
Oh, no wonder they're both so good. I'll have the cheaper one at Lenny's.
Denny's.
Try our delicious steak and shrimp special for just $6.99. Only at Denny's.
Hi, I'm Sonia Van Sickle. Join us Monday for Daybreak. We'll visit an exhibit featuring the work of Frida Kahlo. She overcame great physical pain to produce a myriad of paintings and drawings. That plus all the news and a look at the final four teams. It's all on Daybreak at 6 a.m. on Channel 8.
Saturday nights, be sure to tune into the sizzling music and keep in step with the hottest dance moves on the Latin Connection. Tonight at 12:30 on Channel 8, The Spirit of Texas.
Tomorrow we'll have cloudy skies, some rain, and then a little sunshine. Tomorrow being Easter Sunday, I'll have the extra special weather forecast for you tonight at 10.
Same old rinky-dink lot, same old power box.
What are you doing here?
Too many cops at the wake. I felt like I stopped in for donuts.
That's not how I remember Thomas. It felt... Nothing's changed. Some things. Where's Charlie? Charlie said he wanted to spend more time with Margaret and the kids.
Yeah.
You coming to poker Tuesday? Jay Radakowski?
This is how I think of Thomas. Quarterback, number 9, all Maryland. You would end Charlie at halfback? Do you remember that old PA system? McGavin, you all, takes the snap. Put! Hands it off to Radakowski. Radakowski fumbles, but wait, it's scooped up by Armas. Who takes it? And he goes to... Come on, block for me. You can't hold on to the ball. You can block for me. Come on! Armas breaks into the secondary. Take him out. Did you see that block? A beautiful block.
Yeah, Radakowski.
Take him. Boom. 20 to 10.
Boom.
And touchdown. Yes. Yes. Yes.
Only once, damn it. Only once.
Once. Once was immortal. Once gives me bragging rights forever. Remember they used to call us the Rainbow Tigers?
Oh, yeah.
Thomas the Mick, Charlie the Black.
Me the Pollock, you the Jew.
Santiago Van Brock. Oh, man, what a team we had. Thomas. He was a spark plug, wasn't he? So, you meet Claire's new boyfriend, William?
Yeah. He seems pretty bald
when he seems as bald.
William the Bald.
Billy the Bald. Claire and Billy the Bald. I kept picturing this longshoreman in bed with Claire. I never pictured bald. I don't know, it's funny. Claire going at it with Billy the Bald.
Steven!
I'm coming.
It's cold.
Why don't you sit in the taxi?
Well, how long are you gonna be?
I'll be right there.
Why don't you go sit in the taxi? What is that? That's Marie. What's her? That's Tony's wife.
They're separated. We bumped into each other at the wake.
Bumped? You can't go out with Tony's wife.
We're not going out. She saw me play with the band a couple of times. She just wanted to talk.
Don't you ever stop? Can't you keep your pants on one day?
She only wants to talk.
How can you go on a date the same day that Thomas is buried?
It isn't a date.
Oh, right.
Look, I don't tell you how to live your life.
All I'm trying to tell you, man...
I know what you're trying to tell me. But out. Besides, unlike you, I don't happen to believe that every contact between a man and a woman has to end up in bed.
We found it this morning. Belongs to one Jesse Tanton. He's already taken a fall twice as a low-level drug dealer.
You picked him up?
Mr. Tanton claims he was home all night watching TV. Usual witnesses, wife and all. Says he went out at midnight, found him. This is reported. Like
yeah,
the
you're not
citizen.
Buying that, are you?
Look, I'm thinking about it just the way you do. The guy was carrying drugs. Maybe it was on him. Doesn't want to get found out. So he dumps the car, dummies up an alibi, reports it's stolen.
So how did we get?
We're trying to lift some prints off the car, but it's been wiped clean.
How did we get in?
We probably don't.
Hey, McDaniel, you think I like this any better than you do?
That's my car.
Hey, you guys are terrific finding it this quick and everything. I mean, that's wonderful.
Dad, could you come down to the real precinct house to make a statement?
Yeah, listen, your car here, it was involved in an accident.
Yeah, I heard the jerk who stole it used him to hit and run. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, well, there was a police officer involved.
Yeah, that really crossed me. And I'll tell you, if there's anything I can do to help, you just let me know.
Yeah. Mrs. McDaniel?
Oh, God.
Why not?
Because it's not my area.
You're a criminal lawyer. This is a criminal
matter. A cop can't go around punching out civilians.
We are talking about the guy who killed Thomas.
How does he know that? How can he be so sure?
And besides, Danny didn't punch him. He just pushed him over.
Even if that is true, the kid is still wrong. Look, the criminal charges are pure bull. If anything, it's the police departmental hearings that'll handle.
Then help him. Use your contacts. You know the police brass from your time in the DA's office.
Someone else, someone who's done it before.
Who? Who, some jerk from the Fraternal Order of Police?
Steve, but this just isn't for me.
Poker Tuesday? My place?
I love Tamar.
Look, let's get down to home truths. You won't defend Danny because you don't like him.
That's true.
Oh, unlike some of the sterling characters you helped return to the streets.
That's a stupid argument, and you know it. I don't have to like everyone I defend.
Exactly. So why not Danny?
Because it's his fault that Thomas is dead.
What?
If the stupid jerk hadn't have gone running after that lousy purse snatcher, Thomas would still be here today.
I was there.
I don't care what you say.
If Danny hadn't gone after that guy, Thomas would have anyway.
I don't care. As far as I'm concerned, he's responsible.
The night I operated on Thomas, he was under anesthesia. He never regained consciousness after the accident. I was keeping him alive on the machine. But even if I'd have stopped all the bleeding, even if I'd have sewed up all the cuts and mended all the bones, it wouldn't have mattered. So, why was I doing it? I wanted to be a hero. I wanted you guys to think how terrific I was to save my friend's life. No matter that he'd never come out of a coma, that nothing would ever come out of all the pain I was inflicting except more pain. So I let them turn off the machine. And I watched his body die. It was the right thing to do. I know it was the right thing to do, but I think about it every night. Because maybe there'd have been a miracle. They happen sometimes. I've seen them. Do you believe that, Charlie? Do you? Do you think that's possible? Because if you do, you have to hold me responsible for Thomas's death, too.
6-topping supreme pizza from Pizza Hut. Get one medium for $8.99 or two for just $4 more.
And now a word from a man who refuses to take the Drixoral his pharmacist recommended for 12 hours of cold relief. Drixoral, the cold medicine pharmacists recommend most.
Here's something extra from Selsun Blue. Extra medicated Selsun Blue.
It's extra medicated for the symptoms of my serious dandruff.
It has an extra medicine, plus the ingredient recommended most by doctors. Extra medicated Selsun Blue.
He can't sleep.
Would you like me to come up?
Yes.
He can't relax. Whenever Zach Hutton falls in love...
Is this a bad time?
He really falls. Skin Deep, the comedy that glows in the dark. Rated R. Now playing at theaters everywhere.
I thought when I was a kid that I could make it through the world without school. And when I tried, I wasn't able to do it without stealing.
4 out of 5 teenagers appearing before juvenile court are functionally illiterate.
Finishing school before I got locked up meant nothing to me. School didn't mean nothing. I thought I had everything I needed. A lot of kids think of school as a prison almost, that they have to go and they have no choice. But when you really think about it, the reality of it is school's there for them. The school is there for the kids. The kids got to learn in school to make it out in the world. Getting my GED will give me a real sense of accomplishment. After all that years of going and fighting it and then going on my own will give me a sense of accomplishment that I did actually do something even though I tried to fight the system.
Literacy. Our future begins with basic skills. For literacy information, call this number.
This week on the Monday Mystery Movie, a daring prison escape, a shocking fashion risk, and scandalous forward women.
Are we going to bed or what?
You do what you have to do.
B.L. Stryker, Monday.
Okay, now don't worry. I glanced over your file on my way over here. This will just be a preliminary meeting, but I want you to let me do all the talking, all right?
You know where the interview rooms are?
What are you doing here?
They said we're talking.
What is this?
No, I'm not going anywhere. You want to talk? We'll talk right here.
All right. I worked out a deal for
you. Look, this is ambulance chasing of the worst order. Officer McDonald has
McDaniel.
The right... Officer McDaniel has the right to counsel of his choice.
When I'm done talking, the kid can do whatever he wants. Until then, why don't you just be quiet?
Hey, I won't be bullied.
Shut up. Why are you here?
I'm here because your brother was my friend. Because it matters to people I care about what happens to you. Enough. I've already talked to Tanton's lawyer and the deputy commissioner for public affairs. What everyone wants, the DCPA, Tanton, and you, if you're smart, is to get out of this with as little embarrassment as possible. Tanton has agreed to drop all charges if you'll 1, retract all statements and accusations, and 2, offer a personal apology.
Over my dead body.
Listen to me, Danny.
No, I'm not going to do it.
Do you know anything about Department of
Hearings? First he kills my brother and he gets off
scot-free.
It's
like a kangaroo court in there.
And then just to make everything
anything
absolutely
to
perfect,
you from a slap on the wrist to loss of
absolutely
rank,
not.
Right up to dismissal
Tanton
from the force.
Scum. He's a liar, he's a killer.
We're not talking about Tanton. We're talking about you. Are you ready to go back to civilian life?
As opposed to kissing the backside of the man that killed my brother? You're damn straight.
Then look at it this way, Danny. If you get kicked off the force, what harm have you done to Tanton? At least if you stay on, you can still go after him.
No, I won't do it.
Danny, all you have to do is say the words. No one's going to believe that you mean them, and everyone gets to save face.
Yeah, right. Is this what Thomas would have done, huh? Thomas, the departmental hero. Thomas, the perfect cop. Thomas, the saint. Is this what he would have done? Apologize? Hey. Would you do it?
Yeah, can I get out? Whoa!
I'd like to get
Sorry.
Excuse me.
Hi, Stephen, sorry, Radikowski. He's not in his office, and he was expecting
me. Mr. Armis?
Yeah?
Dr. Radikowski asked if you meet him in OR 7.
Oh, that's... Steve? Too easy. The Shirelles. Obviously not the Mamas and the Papas.
What year?
Who do you think you're dealing with? Came out in 59 and was a big hit in 1960.
You're coming to poker Tuesday. Best 2 out of 3. I win, you come to poker. You win, I do whatever this dumb thing is you came to talk me into.
Steven.
Hi, Claire.
For Zach?
No, it's for you. It's an engagement present.
Surprise.
Yeah.
This is a joke, isn't it? This has something to do with William.
Well, Claire, that's...
I saw the way you were looking at him at the funeral. I know what you were thinking.
What?
It's a toupee, am I right?
Toupee?
I know your so-called sense of humor. Making fun of Claire. A very sweet man because of a small physical defect.
Defect? No, this is...
I hate you when you're like this. You get together with your old high school buddies, your macho men friends like this one, and they egg you on. They make you think these stupid schoolboy pranks are so funny.
No, Claire, really, this is
It's
dumb.
A toupee, isn't it?
Wow. Look, Claire, I got you handkerchiefs, you know, because... I know how much you like lace, so I got...
It's got the lace on there.
Oh,
it's
no.
Pretty, you know, but...
Oh, I'm so
matter.
Sorry.
It's okay.
Oh, I don't know what...
I understand, really.
It's okay. I feel like such a... Please forgive me, Stephen.
I just want to congratulate you on your engagement. It's
yeah,
wonderful
it
news.
Like,
thank you.
I don't know if you want tea, sir.
Thank you.
Guess we'll just stay out here and wait for Zach, okay?
Oh, yeah, no, please, please. Wouldn't you like to come in?
That's really nice of you, Claire. Thanks a lot.
How is he?
He's still in there.
Hey.
That was beautiful.
I loved it.
Thanks.
Well, you got my number.
Hey, man, no hard feelings, huh? Hey, come on, I'm just...
Danny!
Danny.
Stay away from me.
I'm telling you, I'm leaving after this hand no matter what. The wife has spoken.
Harvey, you're whipped. You're whipped. Paul, obviously, you'll stay. You have no wife. Your life is in the toilet. They've been to you.
Oh, the assistant chief of surgery. Obviously, this man's bedside manner got him where he is today. I think what I'll do is just die in peace over here.
Well, I'll call and I'll raise. What's the max?
20.
Only 20? Okay, I'll raise 20.
Leroy.
What's he gonna do?
Crash and burn. I'll see you.
Harvey? I'm done. I'm well done.
You want to see me?
Yeah, I see you.
You really want to see me?
I want to see your cards.
Beginner's luck.
What'd you do? Take
him.
All
right. Okay. Take it easy, fellas.
Fight back, Harvey.
This goes along with the pot. Found it in the attic. I was going to throw it out.
Annie in. Game 7, stud high-low for those men still left at the table.
Come on, Charlie. Come on. Harvey left his losers.
don't count your money in front of me, will you, Jim? It really annoys me.
Hey, I'm serious. Put it in your pocket or something.
Hey, Charlie. Okay? You gonna, like, bluff me on this hand now?
I want to know, Steve.
At 3. What's this game?
7 stud.
Oh, 7 stud.
We'll be back in a moment.
Only Kentucky Fried Chicken has the Colonel's original recipe of 11 herbs and spices. So when you want that one and only taste, come on over to our side of the road.
Cross the road to Kentucky Fried Chicken, yeah. Cross the road.
I notice we're seeing a lot more of you guys since we moved to the beach.
We have a lot of friends near the beach. You just happen to be on the beach.
I love this wine. What is it?
White Grenache. It's new.
They got a great write-up in the paper.
I read that. Is this the one?
Yeah.
So it's impossible to get now, right?
Not if you know the right people.
Ernest and Giulio Gallo introduce a remarkable new wine. White Grenache. It will change the way you think about Gallo.
Sunday at a special time.
Let my people go.
The most spectacular film of all is a holiday classic. Charlton Heston is Moses, the Ten Commandments.
Next on Men.
I can never understand why I make men nervous.
How should I know?
I got sort of a personal problem.
Bathroom.
It won't do any good.
I'll close my eyes.
Oh, my God.
We're even. You slept in my bed. Don't think I didn't notice.
I hope we can still be friends.
Why aren't you flirting with me?
Oh, tonight I can't. She needs an appendectomy.
Got it.
Oh, that's great.
Get this crap out of here and bring me some ice cream.
Pastrami on rye.
I'm watching my weight.
This is ABC.
Senator Phil Graham is ready to put on the gloves to fight for Super Collider funding.
The worst oil spill in U.S.